Hey guys, it's Saru, and I get asked a lot about features that aren't explained very well, or asked for tips when it comes to Swords of Legends Online. So, I'm going to give you guys 10 amazing tips that will make your gameplay that much better. So, let's get right into it. For the first tip, it's matchmaking. I think one of the major things that players complain is about getting into a queue, waiting, and then finally entering a match only to find out that the dungeon is practically done, and everyone is at the last boss already. So you can actually fix this by going over to your matchmaking menu and clicking this little button that says accept matchmaking. Is it weirdly translated? Yes, but will it fix your issue? Definitely. So you won't have to suffer waiting and then finding out that you're going to the last boss instead of clearing the full dungeon as you wanted. So, easily done. Number 2, Soulforce and how it works. This one's a bit interesting because it's not really explained at all in the game whatsoever. So if you have your soul chest, which you should select the option that you want, and you'll have an item that you just need to right click on. Now, at this point, people are stuck, right? So just basically use this item, as I said, that you got from the chest, head on over to Cloud Rise and talk to this fancy young man, and simply purchase a dragon accessory. From there, when you soul socket the item that you wanted, you'll be able to with the Soulforce that you selected. Number 3, housing tips. One of the cool things you can do when you're doing your entire housing thing is, well, plant your house wherever you want. A recommendation to you is if you have a guild, or if you don't, look up We the Peepo. If you have a guild or a group of friends, select an area that you can all be neighbors in. This will allow them to easily visit your place and add soul force, and no, it's not the same soul force that we just talked about, but basically it just means blessing your garden free of charge, and you'll get extra materials for it, and it's easy as pressing F. Plus, you can easily fly to them or teleport quicker if you really wanted to. Number 4, summoning companions. So if you're bored of being alone and you're doing some quests or just need to kill some mobs, you can actually take out your companions by clicking this icon right here, which may not be in this specific location for you guys, but that's where I put it at least. You can actually summon up to 2 companions and just do whatever you want for a limited amount of time. You can also redo this summon every 10 minutes. Number 5, the mentor system. You may have heard of the mentor and apprentice system, but if you head on over to it with Control O or just normally, you can quickly get some fantastic rewards simply by partnering up with your mentor or apprentice and getting rewarded for it. Make sure to check that out because you're limited to it once a week. Number 6, captain's assistant. I did mention this in a previous video, but this neat feature is similar to that of deadly boss mods on World of Warcraft. So simply click under your minimap on this specific icon, and when you're in a fight, or if you've wiped, or if you're actually currently in a fight, you can actually set this up to give you alerts when something's about to go down, such as this boss, and you can do it mid-fight if you really want to. Now, this is only for your current session while you're logged in, and this will wipe, but the events that you create for the notifications will stay forever as long as you don't delete them. And also, you can actually export these alerts when share it with other people that they can import by themselves, and then everyone will have the same alerts, basically. Number 7, Dungeon Codex. If there's one thing that actually works really well with the captain's assistant, it's the dungeon codex. By going here, you can learn about the dungeon you're visiting, the bosses, their abilities, what they do, and it'll be a quick reference for when they do specific skills and you want to save it over to your captain's assistant if that's what you want. But it's also a nice way to prepare yourself for a battle. Number 8, hiding players' effects and numbers. Now, I've seen this before in my comments section asking how to do this. Now, if you head on over to your game settings and you go over to the advanced section and scroll down, you can lower it and increase it, and you can actually configure your tab selection as well. But not only can you hide the effects, you can also hide your damage and healing numbers from this, which actually should help with your frames for some reason. In addition to this, you can actually hide players by activating the player options on the top left of your screen right here, and then clicking on hide players, and then hide teammates or hide enemies. My recommendation to you, especially for PvP related things, is to have hide players on, including your teammates, but keep your enemies unticked at all times. This will actually help you in case you forget, because doing battlegrounds with ghosts isn't that fun. Number 9, shortcut settings. I've seen people quit the game because they simply can't stand the keybinds and aren't sure how to change it. Well, you can. If you simply press the escape button and then go to shortcut settings, from there you can completely change your keybinds to whatever you want. I don't recommend the default keybinds unless you have a demonic hand that loves arthritis, but just to include it in this as a small follow-up, you can assign these to whatever quick bar you want if you want to do that. You can even go into your interface settings to activate a quick bar if you want to add an extra one, and just adjust the size of how it'll look and the overall size percentage of how huge it'll be. Number 10, using your collectibles. One of the cool things about this game is that when you're off to the world of Sword Legends looking for treasures, you can come across some collectibles, and some of them are usable. Simply head on over to your collectibles and drag it over to your bar, and you can actually use these. For example, you can become a duck, just like I have right here. There are other ones that you can summon cats, or whatever the case, just special little things to try, just like this cloak. And if you want to stop the effect, you can simply hover over to the effect buff that you have on, and then just right click, and it'll completely cancel the effect from the collectibles. And finally, the search function. Though this makes it number 11 technically, this is the top best thing in the game. If you press Control F in the game, you'll find a cool search function to find anything you want in the game. You can even link it in chat if you want to by pressing Control left click on the item itself. This can actually tell you where to find things, how to get them, and even reference items that may not be in the game just yet. I will say right now, it doesn't work with uppercase, so lowercase will actually be the way for you to look for things. So, if you see things in global chat, like, I don't know, from the top of my head, maybe an item level 330 gear piece and you're wondering who's hacking, it's probably from here. Don't freak out. So hopefully this helps you guys in the game with traversing the cool places that it has to offer and maybe even optimize your frames a little bit. Let me know if you guys have any questions or if you want to know any more tips in the comments below. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe and click that adorable f***ing bell to know when I upload a brand new video. And don't forget to come join my Discord if you want to chat and hang out. Much love, and as always, till next time, friends.